D'abord, peut-être pour les francophones, il y aura une transcription ou une traduction en français plus tard. So, during the week, we've been talking a lot about fonts and things. There are just a few things that we didn't cover that I thought I'd do lightning talks about. I gave a talk in the Debian development room at the last FOSDEM, so this is just a quick summary. So, maybe you've seen this one? Sorry? What?
Can you go back once?
Yeah, so. So there's the English language, but there are about 1,000 other languages that are also very interesting. So maybe you've heard about this, but this has been growing over the past year since the last LGM. More people have joined the Debian team to help with reviewing fonts, packaging them, interacting with upstream, and we have something that is useful to the wider open font community and others. We run a weekly review detailing all the fonts that we know about the archives, and we generate specimens, we extract all the metadata, we compute the Unicode coverage, we run font lint on it to expose some of the problems with tables and so on. So if you want to find a place where there's already some analysis going on, then this is a start. Of course, the work that is going on for the Open Font Library will go beyond what we currently have, but this is a start. So to get good open fonts, you have these five concepts. Having them widely available, that it would be complete enough, that in the eyes of the people using the script, that it would reach the sufficient level of quality and also handle the subtleties that they have in a particular language, and that it would be accessible, that people without deep pockets and a lot of education will also get access to these open fonts and writing systems. So small is more and less is beautiful, or something. It's great to have beautiful fonts, but sometimes they aren't even accessible. So this is why many in the community are recommending this model, where we find the nexus between the needs of the designers who actually produce the fonts and the free software values of modification and redistributions. If you're looking for a particular font, there are various places also where you can go to, like the Unifont Font Guide. Over the past year, there's been a number of interesting new releases coming from different angles, coming from various places, different parts of the community. We had the Greek Font Society releasing a lot of revivals as well. We had individuals committing to working on fonts. We had agencies like UNESCO, other foundations commissioning open fonts. We had different types of fonts, monospace, pixel, math, symbols, and so on. And we also had Ascenders, a major foundry, being commissioned to do fonts like Droid or Liberation. And if you want to go one step beyond that and try and get familiar with the toolkit like we did in the workshop, there's a meta package that you can install. So it will pull in a number of useful things. You can give it a try. An increasing number of fonts are starting to get hosted under revision control. They've showed the Open Baskerville project on GitHub, but there are other places too. And we've seen a lot of very interesting progress on the main element of the toolkit, FontForge, so that's already been described. The good thing for designers is that you can theme FontForge now. I've been doing that for some of the designers here, and suddenly looks a lot nicer like that. Once you're familiar with the toolkit, then you want to start a release. There are best practices, there are recommended things that you can go from. The font log is this kind of font design oriented changelog. Well, lots of interesting and useful information for people who want to branch an existing font. There's the full open font sources template, which describes the various formats that font sources, extended font sources, can can be stored in. And then there's the whole thing about metadata, which we discussed already. So ways you could possibly help out. Well, I guess the obvious would be try and see if there, when there's a need that comes up, if you can use an existing open form. Advocating the model around you, you're very clever hackers. You could extend the toolkit. You could host things that you do. And you could use the VCS template also as a reference for the upstreams. If you're close to a specific distribution, you might consider joining the fonts team and helping out also with the advocacy. You could consider how these fonts can be usefully bundled in some of your applications. And then, well, this is going on with the text layout meeting, but you could also study how some of the more complex needs can be implemented, or you could reuse some of the features to make your design, Libre design applications more multilingual. So there's a planet. If you want to follow the various RSS feeds of people in the open font community, you can add that to your reader. There's the stuff from the unifont.org website also. We have a campaign, materials that you can use if you need like a formal letter of support to an upstream foundry or personal designer. The major community bodies have given support to this campaign. So we have a letter and everything. So this is a resource that you can use. And now our next steps, well, getting the Open Font Library fully launched, seeing what can happen obviously on the web fonts side of things, and then on the mobile devices, I think there's a definite need to. We have a lot of plans for design workshops. So if you're interested, come along or make them known at least with OSPs and Dave's work and so on. And hopefully soon we're there. So that's it. Any questions, comments?